Good evening, and welcome to the Chicago Chapter National Black Nurses Association Health is Wealth program, monthly program. I'm Reverend Evelyn Collier-Dixon, and I'm your host for today. We have Ms. Janice Henry, who is our telephone host and our television program coordinator, where our president is Ms. Ellen Durant, and we are a culturally competent nursing professional organization consisting of registered nurses, licensed practical nurses, and student nurses. And we also just want to recognize that our host, who is on leave right now, is Ms. Brunetta Pearson, and we wish her well. And we just want to open up this program today, and I have a special guest with me, and I'm going to let him tell you who he is. Good evening. What's your name?
Darius.
Darius. Okay. Welcome to the show, Darius. Okay. And Darius is my grandson. And what we're going to be talking about today, I thought it was very interesting that I would bring Darius with me, apart from being babysitting. I also thought it would be interesting to bring him with me so we can discuss some back to school health tips. Okay, Darius has already started school, but many of you have not, and we want the parents as well as the children to be well informed when they go back to school, okay? So, back to school is an exciting time for both the kids and the parents. As they come from the holidays, a long summer, many parents are so busy preparing their children for the new term that they forget to prioritize the health part for their children. Sometimes kids cannot control themselves and they end up overindulging in unhealthy food. Okay, they have so much fun that they eat the wrong kind of snacks. Is that right, Darius? Mm-hmm. Interacting with different people can make them vulnerable to communicable diseases, you know, colds and that type of thing. And eating too much junk can be very unhealthy for the children. And you know that, right, Darius? You have to eat healthy, right? Okay, so we want to share with our audience today some tips on how we can prepare them as they go back to school. Now, us being a nursing organization, of course, our concern is about health care. So we're going to be presenting from a health care perspective, okay? First of all, after a long summer break, it is time for the kids to head back to school and to focus on their classwork. Some will be engaging in sports and other activities after school. But as you can get adjusted to that first month of school, it's a good idea to take some precautionary measures to set up for a safe, healthy back-to-school year. And we're going to present you with some of the tips that you need to have as you go back to school. Now, children normally don't like this part of it, but I have to tell you, you got to get your vaccination. You got to get your vaccination because you need to have your immune system needs to be built up against those diseases that those children will bring to you. They're coughing and they're not covering their mouth areas like you shared with me that some do, you know, cough in your face. Some would do that, okay? Everybody not well-mannered, so you have to be prepared. And by getting your vaccination, that will help to immune you from those communicable diseases. Now, many schools require that the children have vaccinations before they go back and before they even enroll for the first time. So what we would recommend that you do is talk to your child's health care provider or doctor or whomever that person might be to ensure that they get their flu shots, their immunizations that are needed for their age appropriateness, okay? So we want to make sure that everyone have a flu shot at least so that you can be protected against those colds and respiratory things that children will bring. And not only children bring them, but also adults can bring those things, put that back there, back to you. We want to set bedtime. Darius, I need you to listen to me this. Bedtime timing, okay? It's very important that you get your proper sleep, okay? Because when you go to school, you don't want to go to school and be all tired and your teacher is trying to teach you and you're sitting there asleep. So it's very important. It is essential for kids as well as adults to get a healthy amount of sleep each night to stay focused throughout the day, because you certainly want to stay focused. That's a part of the learning process, because if you're sleepy and the rest of the kids are engaging and you're asleep, then you're going to miss out on a whole lot. Right, Darius? Okay, right. And although sleep requires varies sometimes from individual to individual, some adults may not require as much sleep as others, but we recommend adults as well as children get at least 8 hours of sleep. Do you understand what I'm saying? So that means you need to go to bed, because you have to get up early enough, Darius, to go to school and be on time, okay? So we recommend that you get at least 8 hours of sleep. So that means once you take your bath, after you eat your dinner, take your bath, it's time for you to go to sleep so you can get the proper amount of sleep that you need, okay? And to get your children ready to get up early in the morning, so they need to go to sleep early so they can get up early, we have to consider making their bedtime a little bit earlier each night. Now, that's going to be hard after coming off a long summer when you had very little or any discipline, when you could stay up as late as you like. But going back to school, you need to prepare to go to bed early. And what you also have to do is stick to the routine. So if your bedtime is 8:30 every night, then that's what you need to do every night, is go to bed about that time. So stick into it. Now, on the weekends, your mom and your dad might allow you to stay up a little bit longer, right? Mm-hmm. And watch your YouTube and your videos, right, Darius? Because you like that, don't you?
I keep doing it.
Yeah, but you have to learn to go to bed during the school days so that you can won't be tired, and when your teachers talk to you, you can know exactly what she's saying, and you can be the smartest kid in that room.
When y'all wake me up, I won't be sleepy anymore.
Exactly. When you get your proper amount of rest, when we wake you up in the morning, you won't be sleepy, right? You won't be grumpy and I need some more sleep, because you will have gotten your 8 hours. So it's very important, and I want the viewing audience, the kids in the viewing audience, as well as their parents to know how important it is to get your sleep, okay? All right. We also want to teach good hygiene. With so many people around us with germs and it's lurking in the classroom, it's just those germs when they sneeze, Darius, and it just goes into the air. We want to help you to prevent you from getting and bringing those germs home. Because if you bring those germs home, then what's going to happen is your parents is going to get them at it. Your parents is going to end up with it. So we need to make sure that those germs are not lurking. It's important for you to wash your hands. Do you know how important that is? Every time you go to the bathroom, you have to wash your hands. Every time you sneeze or cough, you need to wash your hands. Good hand washing is very important in preventing and spreading germs, okay? And then wash your hands, make sure you wash them with soap and warm water, okay? All right? And we have to teach you how to do that. There's a process. After you eat snacks, after you use the bathroom, you know what? You like the hand sanitizer, don't you? Because you were asking me about my hand sanitizer. It's a good thing to put some of that in your backpack, because so often you're not able to get to the bathroom and you can just use the hand sanitizer. So Granny's going to get you some hand sanitizer for your backpack, okay? Mm-hmm. All right. We should introduce you to not to share your food or drink. And it's not that you're being selfish, because we always know that sharing is caring, right? Okay, but we want to make sure that when you share your food, because sometimes when you take food from other kids, you don't know what kind of germs that they have. Okay, they may have coughed on the food. So be very careful when you share your food. I know at the school you like to sit around and share your snacks. If those snacks are in the pack, it's okay, but if they're loose, be very careful because you don't want to get germs. And you don't know if they wash their hands or not, do you? And you don't want to be eating something that's germy, right? Okay, so what we need to do, parents, we need to stock up on healthy food, okay? Not just the fast food. I know we're all guilty of after school going straight to McDonald's or Burger King. I'm not advertising either one, but I'm just keeping it real. You know, we like to go straight to the fast food places, and that becomes our children dinner. And we all are guilty of that, okay? Because mom is tired. Child is tired at the end of the day, but we want to make sure that our children are eating healthy foods, okay? It might be easy to pack your kids' lunch with pre-made snacks, okay? Healthy carrots and lettuce and that kind of stuff that to keep you from eating junk food. And I know at your school, they don't allow you to eat certain foods like certain kinds of meat.
You have to eat your own food first if you want to eat snacks.
Oh, you have to eat your own food first if you want to eat snacks.
That's what I do.
And that's what you do. Well, you're in compliance, Darius. That's very good. Okay? And it makes it easier for yourself by stocking up on healthy foods like fruit, vegetables, whole grain bread, protein, like lean protein, like turkey. You eat your vegetables?
I eat my vegetables at my old school, but I don't know how they taste now.
You don't know how they taste now because you ate them at your old school. So what we have to do, since we packed your lunch, is introduce you to vegetables at your new school. How about that? Okay. We have to take a few minutes during the weekend to cut those fruit up and those vegetables and prepare them and have them ready and put them in the Ziploc bag so that we won't have to rush in the morning trying to prepare the food. Okay, we have to buy plenty of containers, those, like I said, the Ziploc bags, so that you can carry your vegetables and fruit to school, okay? And we have to consider getting things to preserve.
We have to buy me some vegetables.
We have to buy you some vegetables, right. We are very, very guilty, Darius, of not giving you vegetables, okay?
And yeah, so that's okay.
That's okay? Thank you. So what your mom and I and your dad and I, we're going to have a long talk so that we can reintroduce you to eating vegetables at your new school. How about that? Okay, sounds like a good deal, right?
One person eats vegetables in my new school.
One person does? Okay, so they're eating healthy, right? Okay, so that's a good
answer. All they do is be eating soup.
Soup? Well, I don't know about soup because sometimes soup has so much salt in it and it's prepared already. Unless they made some good soup at home. Mom made some good soup at home with vegetables in it. Mm-hmm. So that would be good, right? All right.
I don't like my vegetables.
Yeah, okay. You know, that's okay. We'll talk about that after we the show, okay? All right. We want to also be still. We want to manage the stress. Everybody just know that Darius is 5 years old, and I think he's doing a wonderful job being patient. Okay. All right. So we want to manage the stress of our children. Back to school season is stressful for kids as well as the parents. And too much stress can lead to various health issues, like what we call insomnia. And insomnia is a medical name for, term for not able to sleep, okay? Sluggish immune system. The immune system just doesn't work the way that it's supposed to, and it doesn't fight off the viruses the way it's supposed to because stress can cause the immune system to be sluggish. And we have to help manage stress by talking to our children about things that bother them. If something bothers you, Darius, then Granny and your parents need to sit down and, again, we need to sit down and talk to you about it. And Darius, how was your day today? And then you're able to share what happened. And I know we talk to you and ask you how your day is all the time, and you share with us about, and that's what parents should do, is share with your children, because sometimes they go through things during the day, and you really need to know what's going on with your children, okay? And we want to be careful not to overload our schedules, because if you overload the schedule, if you got too much to do, then that causes stress, because you're trying to make the deadlines, you're trying to do your homework, you're trying to do this, you're trying to do sports, you're trying to do all of those things, but that causes stress. And when you're stressed because you can't make the deadlines, then that causes you to have, could cause you to have medical issues. Schoolwork and after-school activities are very important, but it is also essential to take time to relax, to play, and to spend time with your family. And I would say pray. Take some time to have prayer time and Bible study time, because that is also a critical part of relieving stress also. And I'm just saying that from my own perspective as a grandparent and also as a spiritual advisor. Going back to school, as parents, you want your children to get through the school term without complications of visiting the doctor. And a way to ensure that is that you keep that body in good alignment. The best time to book an appointment for your child is before they go back to school. So if you haven't already, you need to get it in and get that appointment in so that we can, the doctors can let you know, give you some baselines as to where your child is, okay, healthy or need to improve in this area and build up that immune system. So take your children early to get their appointments so that they can go back to school and be in a healthy state once they go back to school. Because if they're not in a healthy state, they're not going to learn the way that they're supposed to, okay? Okay, the doctor, the healthcare provider will help your kids to stay healthy by updating their immunization, the vaccines, which prevent serious diseases, as we said early on. This also safeguards the health of their classmates. Take your hand down. Okay, and we just need to make sure that we have a check-off list of what we have done for our children and what needs to be done before they go back to school. And one of the things that we want to stress to you is make sure that they go to for their dental appointments, okay? Dentist, go to the dentist, because it's important. It's just as important as getting the vaccinations, and it should be a requirement of going back to school. Okay, tooth decay causes pain, difficulty in chewing, speaking, as well as learning. Okay, dental checkups can help to diagnose and treat any dental disease, such as cavities and gum diseases. Okay. So we also want to know that some of the common illnesses in our children are kids get sick regularly because their immune system is not strong as those of us as adults. And some common diseases that we have to watch out for our children are simple common cold, okay? The flu. We have to make sure that we protect our children by getting the flu shot. And a lot of people say, well, flu shot for a child? Of course. Even for an infant, you get the flu shot for them, okay? Stomach flu, okay? That can be very, very critical for a child who is going back to school. Ear infections, and we know about the ear infections, right? Because we were just in the emergency room last week with what? What did you have?
An ear infection.
An ear infection, right. And what do we have to do? We had to get you some medicine, right? And treat that ear infection.
When I go home, I have to eat that, drink that medicine.
Take your medicine, exactly. Because you had a long summer. You went to Mexico, right? And in Mexico, what were you doing? Swimming in the pool,
yeah,
right?
That pool was poisoning.
And I don't know what it was because Grammy was not with you. But in that pool, a lot of water build up in your ears. And you're very susceptible to get an ear infection. And we witnessed that with you. And we had to take you to the emergency room. Thank God for emergency rooms, okay? Children also over the summer could have developed head lice. Okay, and we want to make sure that those are not on your children. You want to make sure that you wash your hair real good and good soap that would prevent that type of infestation. We want to make sure that the pink eye, we call that conjunctivitis, because the pink eye is contagious. And if your child goes to school with the pink eye, chances are they're going to get sent back home because that will spread to another child, spread to the teacher. So we want to make sure, thank you, we want to make sure that all of these things are taken care of. And you can take some care of some serious illnesses at home, okay, as well as going to the doctor. We recommend as healthcare providers that you take it to the doctor, but there are still home remedies that you can use. For instance, a healthcare care person, they will take you to the emergency room, and as I said, we did that with you. And these services are provided, and if you do your home remedies, and you know what home remedies are, those things that for common colds and that type of thing, it'll save you some money as well as some time, but you also want to make sure and ensure that your child has been seen by a physician before you send them back into the public with the children, okay? We basically just talked about everything. We talked about a healthy diet, good habits. Classes have children from different backgrounds. I want to get that in. I got 5 minutes. I'm going to get that in. They're from different backgrounds, different residents, which increases their risk of spreading germs. And one of the easiest way that we can teach our children, again, is to wash their hands. I want to throw in this also as a healthcare provider that we want to make sure that our children report to you anytime there is some form of bullying. Okay, because we see that on the rise now, and children sometimes just kind of mean by nature. But make sure that you establish a relationship with your children, and they feel free to come to you and let you know what is going on in their school setting, even in their home setting, because so often we don't know what these children are going through. But we want to definitely be aware, and we want them to be free enough to come and to share with us. And when they see something, always report it, because we are on high alert now, especially in our schools. We want to make sure that our children feel safe in schools, as well, not just health-wise, but environmental-wise. We want to make sure that if they see something that is abnormal, always report it to those persons that are in authority, okay? And then to deal with that anxiety and that stress, we just want to make sure that your children feel comfortable in talking to you about what's going on in their lives. And we strongly advocate that for parents as well as for children. We want to make sure that you watch out for allergies. Our children have food allergies, and sometimes we don't identify that. And we'll send them to school with a peanut butter sandwich when that child may be allergic to it. So make sure that you know what your child's allergies are, and you can report those as well as take care of those yourself, okay? We just want to start the school year off on a healthy note. We want to ensure that you are comfortable with your child going back into the environment, as well as your child being comfortable. Again, we want to thank you for joining us, the Chicago Chapter National Black Nurses Association. We meet every second Saturday every second Saturday from 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. at the Lutheran School of Theology, 1100 East 55th Street in one of the University of Chicago buildings on the second floor, and come and join us. We would certainly enjoy having you, and you can ask us questions in person. And we trust that you have a wonderful start back to school. And I just want to thank you, Darius, for being my special guest. I think you did a wonderful job, okay? Okay? And I know your parents are going to be very, very proud of you. Thank you. And have a wonderful evening. Yes.